Nine, ten. I'm gonna finish the third ball. 7. Five. వినండి.
Thank you.
tiro. Ei! Two. White, right? White, silk. for those of you joining us this morning at the 2015 Butterfly Badger Open, we're here in the preliminary groups of the under 2500. This is group one with top seed Ernesto versus Micaiah from Lindenwood. These are the top two seeds in the under 2500 group with one advancing. As players get warmed up, we're going to collect some of the results from the rest of the matches of the group and get back to you to see what's going on. Matches in the under 2500 round robin are best 3 out of 5. And both players, Micaiah from Lindenwood and Ernesto in the black and green, have not lost a match yet in their round robin, so the winner of this match will advance into the single elimination rounds. The under 2500 will be the highlight of our day today, the second day at the Badger Open. The open singles and most of the rounds of the open doubles already completed. Ernesto here in black and green. Top seed in the under 2500, Danny C. Miller is second, and Rajat Hubli, the surprise semifinalist in yesterday's open event, is third. John Tone from Mississippi College is fourth. And great matches today in this under 2500 round robin. Many other events will start and end today for a total of 27 events at this year's Butterfly Badger Open. For those of you who are interested in competing in additional Butterfly four-star tournaments, the next one is the South Shore Open in Indiana at the end of October, hosted by Danny C. Miller, especially favorable for junior players with over $5,400 in prize money for the junior events. Ernesto running away with a quick lead in game one, 9-3. Oh, nine. Makai here clawing his way back, staying in game one. Ernesto really dominating on this backhand-to-backhand play. Ernesto took an early exit, but not too unexpected in the open round, losing in the round of 16 to Cheng Li, who then lost to the eventual winner, Chen Rui Chao, in the quarterfinals. Nice forehand rally. Wow. A great start to game. Makai looking more in his element. Sometimes even if you lose a point like that, you feel a little better, like you know what you're doing, you're feeling more confident. Nice forehand attack by Makai right there. Ernesto, after having an easy first game, will have to continue to play hard in game two in order to continue to dominate. Makai is a real fighter, so I don't think he'll let anyone just run away without trying too hard. A little too much there on that forehand, just wasn't quite in position. And you'll see, you'll watch that the ball went kind of straight out instead of having that arc. Kai just didn't quite get that topspin on the ball. Smart move by Makai to go down the line. He already saw Ernesto was waiting on that corner. It's the right idea by Makai, try to go down the line. Smart of Makai to switch up where he's attacking. Ernesto's forehand's really tough. Going to that forehand to giving him that third ball forehand is not the best idea. Oh, serve return is it's giving Makai a little bit of trouble. Pop one up, miss the backhand loop off of that, another one. When you have trouble with serve receive, it can be very difficult to play. Makai looping in the net because it hit Ernesto's finger on the way over, totally legal, but fries a weird kind of feel on the ball. And again, Makai with the down the line loop, smart, it works, just difficult to execute on certain times. Ernesto taking a 2-0 lead, very commanding, showing his stuff as the top seed in this under 2500 event. Makaya getting outplayed a little bit. I've seen Makaya personally beat 2500 level players, but today it looks like Ernesto's just a little too strong. Maya made some great shots in game two, looping down the line. It worked, but it's hard to execute. He's having trouble with serve receive. And just missing a few shots and having a little bit of trouble with serve receive can make the difference between having a really close match and having one where you don't feel like you know what you're quite doing. Nice rally. Big forehand. Oh, nice block by Makaya, the first one. 6-1. Now Ernesto, not too happy with that backhand. Just wasn't quite in position and usually uses forehand to attack that. 6-3. Ernesto not making too many of those backhands. We saw in his match against Chun Li yesterday, Ernesto is actually a big forehand player and doesn't use his backhand too often. Makaya still having trouble with that long serve deep into the backhand. Sometimes it's underspin, sometimes it's topspin. And again, similar error. Lost trouble with serve receive. Haven't seen that serve from Makaya for a while. We've seen this kind of idea, just trying different things at the end if you don't have an answer for something. It's difficult. Long to the forehand is a tough serve for someone to do against Ernesto. 10-4. Big forehand, I think he's going to go with that same serve. Makaya in the rally does okay, but the small stuff in the beginning is where we have the issues. Match point. And again, that topspin backhand long. That serves giving Makaya a lot of trouble. It ultimately made it quite an easy match for Ernesto to win on. So Ernesto will advance in the under 2500 round robin group. We'll bring you the single elimination rounds as they happen. We'll have to wait for the other groups to finish, and the 2500 groups will bring on table one for the rest of the day today. We're going to take a little break, and we'll be back with more matches as soon as they happen.
I never seen this guy, but tell me he's incredible. They tell me that he's gonna kill me.
A nowy aktor, czy jesteście na obciach teraz?
Coaches. For each one, please give me 2 points.
so just talk with Mike Coleman. Okay? Don't put attention to those guys. Okay.
Mike is official coach.
Okay, guys. Blue and white. Who wants to choose?
Blue.
Search your side.
I did give it to him.
Oh,
side. Yeah, okay, understand.
I receive.
Side? He receive?
Yeah,
he receive. Okay, I see.
2 minutes, one.
Welcome back to the 2015 Badger Open. We are in the round of 16, or the eighths. for the under 2500. This is a match between Rajat Hubli, the surprise semifinalist in yesterday's open singles event, the third seed in the under 2500.
3, 2. Hey, go on. Hey.
And Wojciech Wolski. Wojciech was actually a semifinalist in last year's Badger Open. Advancing out of his group, Group 7, upsetting Felipe Morita in order to be in this round of 16 match.
Hey, go on, hey!
Oh, man.
Sorry, man. 3, 4.
I practiced it just now. Sorry. Need more.
Hey, go on. Four. Hey, go on, hey!
We saw yesterday, Rajat has a great forehand, it's a little inside out, and Wojciech is very consistent, great backhand punch, and gives a lot of problems to people who are not used to playing kind of longer rallies. And we'll see if he has the ability to control Rajat's shots in this match.
Hey, go on, hey!
Rajat's forehand's tough to block, and if Wojciech can't control that block, it's going to take Wojciech in the yellow out of his element, making it very difficult. And here for Wojciech, this is the same idea. He has to be able to block Rajat's loops consistently and play his game.
Hey, go!
Wojciech likes long rallies, angling the ball.
No!
And that's tough. Rajat reacted nicely to hit that ball right back.
Come on, Ellie, Ellie!
7-9.
Hey, come on, Ellie, go!
Nice block by Wojciech right there, and that's really what he's good at, but Rajat's forehand is really tough, so I think in the next game Wojciech will have to really like move the block around, but it's tough because Rajat's forehand attack is very, very strong, and he proved that yesterday in the open rounds. So our best 3 out of 5 matches, winner moves on into the quarterfinals.
Michael, hey! No!
Run, hey, go!
Sorry for a little break there. Went to go check on the draw, and this is actually the quarterfinals.
No!
We had 8 groups in the preliminary with 1 advancing, so we have 8 people into this round. So this is the quarterfinal match.
4-6.
Between Rajat Hubli from group 3 and Wojciech Wolski from group 7. Wojciech feeling a little out of his element. He wants to play that counter-hitting, blocking game. It's really tough when your opponent has such a strong forehand and you have trouble controlling it.
Hey!
That forehand is tough to block. It's hard to control. I know because I played Rajat last tournament at the Hyson. And if you don't return that serve, he can just rip it, and it's very difficult to block. It has that inside out that Danny was talking about yesterday when we were watching Rajat play in the open, singles elimination. Rajat really showing his stuff. He had currently resides in Boston, but has been on and off for table tennis, learned to play, played and trained with the Indian national team for many years before coming here. Had a rating as high as 2,600. undoubtedly a favorite for this event, the under 2500, with his top competitors being Ernesto, which we saw on table one earlier in group one, playing his preliminary round, and Dan C. Miller, number two seed. Oh, nice backhand attack. Wojciech knows that he can't play that blocking game with Rajat, right? Because Rajat's forehand's so powerful. Wojciech has to attack first and keep the pressure on. And Rajat's defense isn't as good. But if he attacks first and moves him around, he can do plays like that one where he can push him from one side to the other and back. And then if he could break up that error, so break up the pace, so sometimes he's attacking, sometimes he's pushing, can force some errors from Rajat.
There you go.
From Wojciech. Wojciech is not blocking as much, which is what he normally does, but he can attack. It's really giving him the advantage. Again, if he goes back to pushing and blocking, it's going to be a really tough match for Wojciech. Again, the same thing. If you return and you let Rajat attack, you're starting off on a very, very difficult foot. Not always stepping around.
Four, five.
Wojciech with a 4-1 lead and now down 4-5.
Hey, go on, hey.
Nice block from Wojciech. All the way wide into the forehand. If he can make that block, it's going to be powerful, but five, it's kind of a risky way to go. Smart move, right? Forcing Rajat to play a backhand from away from the table, something that he's not really comfortable with.
Hey, come on. Hey!
Nice blocking by Wojciech. His backhand is very good at blocking and also at attacking. I think stronger than his forehand. And what's key is that he has to return Rajat's serve in a way that Rajat doesn't just kill it. If he can get into the rally, he has an upper hand. Right? Select that serve. It's impossible for Rajat to just kill the serve. 8. Here's that attack. Interesting rally. Both players a little out of their element in that rally, playing away from the table, not punch blocking. Great rally by both of them, good effort. Rajat a little stronger by going to the backhand. Wojciech here looking to make an attack or a good return so Rajat can't attack it. Nice serve. First really long one. Topspin. Rajat didn't have enough time to step around.
Oh my lord.
Here you go. Two more match points for Wojciech in the yellow. Let's see if he can close it out this game. Force the number four. Or if Rajat, who is definitely looking to close 3-0, can bring it back and win four in a row, or at least two in a row, to get into deuce. No, nice backhand block. And as soon as you force Rajat to lift, give you that slightly spinnier, slower backhand, or loop into the backhand, that's where Wojciech feels the most comfortable. He can punch that down the line. It's so quick, it's so difficult to return. And we'll see what happens in this next game. Rajat leads this game, or leads this match 2-1 in this quarterfinal.
1-0. Come on, allez, allez, come on, allez. No! Allez.
Intensity is growing in this match. Rajat knows it's not going to be an easy time. Rajat playing a little differently, not killing everything, pushing. Not a good start for Wojciech.
Hey, go. Got it.
That's tough. The serve receive, if you can't get a serve right, it's almost impossible to block that next loop. Rajat can direct it cross court or down the line. Rajat not pleased about losing that third game, running away here in game 4, 5-0. Nice push by Wojciech, really heavy. Looks like it kind of nicked the edge a little bit. Rajat psyching himself up, he really wants to win this match right now. Definitely doesn't want a fifth game. It's up 5-0, now 5-3. That long topspin serve has been working from Wojciech. Rajat just can't get around fast enough.
There you go. There you go. Yo!
And here, Rajat changing it up. Long topspin serve into Wojciech's forehand, something that he hasn't tried. It's a new strategy. Sometimes what's cool about playing at the higher levels is you have more tools and more options, and sometimes you just turn it on at certain points and surprise your opponent. Wojciech not returning that serve great, but pretty wide, and Rajat just didn't get his feet around fast enough.
Hey, go on. Hey, go.
Wojciech backing up, not his sweet spot, not where he needs to be if he wants to keep staying in this match.
Hey, come on, choke! Hey, choke! Hey, go!
And Wojciech opening with that backhand. Opening with that backhand gave him the advantage in game 3. It's working in game 2. And he has to keep doing it here. See if Rajat changes up the serve, or he's going to go for another step around forehand. I put a little side top on it. And Wojciech went for another push instead of a flip. Going off the side.
Hey, go!
Big forehand coming.
No!
It's difficult when Wojciech can't make that down the line block. It can be really difficult.
Hey, go!
Nice backhand. And that's Wojciech's on unforced error. Just put a little too much on it. 5 match points for Rajat. Nice backhand loops. But that forehand counter move was not what Wojciech wanted. Rajat moves forward in the under 2500 into the semifinal. More quarterfinals to come in the under 2500 round robin event. We'll be starting them on table one soon.
个双打半决赛。Side of the table. You want court? Yeah, okay. After you warm up, I'm going to ask who's going to serve. Okay? Warm up and then I'm going to ask who serve, who receives. Okay? 2 minutes warm up.
Semi-final. Two. 3-3.
For those of you joining us on the live stream, we are watching the semifinals of the Open Doubles event, the 2015 Badger Open. In the blue, we have the team from Indonesia. Really happy to have them here. Traveling all the way from Indonesia to come to the Badger Open. And in black, we have our well-known Minnesota team of Chiwei and Michael Tran, coach student team. Chiwei not happy with those two serves going long.
7-5.
This is the semifinals of the Open Doubles. The Indonesian team in blue here took out 2015 collegiate doubles champions Cheng Li and Zhang Tong in the quarterfinals, or in the round of 16 actually. Indian team really strong, work together a lot, so know what to do in doubles.
9-8.
This is critically important. Chiwei having some issues with the serve. They're really good at flipping any of those no-spin serves. They are doing a great job of just attacking, making it really difficult for Chiwei and Michael to find their groove and get into a rally in a doubles match. Doubles matches are all best 4 out of 7, just like all the single elimination rounds of the open singles. Oh, nice shot by Michael.
1-3.
One of the critical things about playing doubles is getting that first attack, because it's much easier to attack than it is to block in doubles. So you have to not only watch the ball and block, but also get around your opponent.
Four, three.
Michael going just a little early on those counter loops. So wait for the ball just a little longer to make them. And it's difficult in doubles because you're so much more going on.
Yeah.
You should have a little bit of trouble with serve return. If it's short, but any long one, they're great at attacking. Team working very well together in doubles, and what you'll see is that they understand how to attack and where to move.
Six, ten.
And they seem to be moving more effortlessly, getting out of each other's way. These both of these doubles teams have worked together before. Oh, nice little chop block by Michael.
Seven, ten.
The Indonesian team proves its power by taking the second game 11-7. These matches are best 4 out of 7. And this is the semifinals of the Open Doubles event. One of the key things that Michael and Chiwei have to do in this third game to get back into the match is to keep it short, because their attacks are very difficult to block and very quick. You see Chiwei really trying to keep it short and low.
Two.
Keeping it short is key. You have to make sure that push has enough spin, just like that last one, so that the Indonesian team will flip it into the net. Oh, nice forehand.
3-4.
And they're pushing out the wide forehand, trying to keep it short. You'll see that's kind of the switch from the earlier games. Chiwei and Michael Tran pushing everything short. And serving out really wide to the forehand. The right idea to loop that long serve. Michael just didn't quite execute it the way he wanted. He waited just a little too long and went too far up. When you wait for the ball to drop like that, your only option is to go up. And that can be really difficult. Tough loop. Again, in doubles you have to move very smoothly. Oh, nice block by Michael.
8-9.
Standing right there. Oh, nice counter loop from the Indonesian team. And one of the things you have to keep in mind is that for doubles, since you have to move around your opponent, it's really important to try to predict where the ball is going. It's difficult to not only move to the ball, but also get around your opponent. Chiwei, a few of those serves.
9-10.
Already with her nose spin. It's a deep underspin. A little bit lucky there, because I think if that made it, she and then would have lost this game. Indonesian team leads 2-0, and we're 10-10 in the third in this best of seven.
Go! 10-11.
Heavy under. Chiwei's going to go for that big forehand. A little lucky there on the little net dribbler, 12-12. This tight third game in the open doubles semifinal. Oh wow, beautiful counter loop. Michael just lifted that serve, but it was right, just a little too slow. And the Indonesian was right there to pounce on it. Sometimes nets are even. Oh, they got lucky. Picked one up there.
15-14.
Big deuce game in game three. See which team can help close it out. Both teams have had their chances.
Oh.
Nice counter-looping rally by Chiwei and Michael Tran.
16-15.
Giving them maybe their third or fourth game point. And finally, game three. Goes to Chiwei Michael Tran. Pretty epic third game battle. See, keeping the ball short is a strategy that they'll probably use throughout. It worked in the very beginning of game three and it got them to where they were. And in the end, they started serving long just a little bit more and playing out the big rallies. But I think it'd be smart to start game four, keeping the ball short and moving your opponents around to avoid a big forehand shot from either side. Oh, nice counter loop for Michael Tran. If Michael and Chiwei can stay close to the table, they have a lot of opportunity. Nice rally, big forehand. And they can take control of this attacking portion. They really have a chance here. Usually whoever's attacking is winning in doubles, whoever's defending is losing.
Three, four. 4, 4.
A big forehand from Chua didn't quite hit the table. A little far away.
4, 5.
A nice slow loop by Michael Tran forces an error from the over-the-table counter loop. It's an interesting dynamic for the doubles play. Sometimes changing up the speed is more powerful than giving a big shot. Wow, they're really looping into Chiwei's backhand. The Indonesian team attacking into Chiwei's backhand and flipping the serves. Really good at flipping the serves. Causing a lot of issues on from Chiwei and Michael Tran. 10-5, hoping for a 3-1 lead here in the semifinals.
11-5, 3-1.
Indonesian team takes a 3-1 lead in this best of 7 semifinals for the Open Singles event. We're about to get started with game 5 here. And I see it's a little bit of an uphill battle for Michael Tran and Chiwei. The Indonesian team has just, one key piece that they're better at is flipping the serve. Nice backhand by Michael. Yes, the inability to really attack the serve is really hurting Chiwei and Michael Tran.
1-1, let me.
Again, in doubles, it's usually whoever is attacking is winning.
3-2.
Nice block, nice backhand move from away from the table from Michael.
5-3. Moving up.
Well, nice counter looping rally. Really good rally here. Both teams have know how to play with each other, but again, the Indonesian team in blue, a little bit better at serve receive. Taking a very commanding lead in 8-4. And when you're good at serve receive and good at the small shots, it's easy to be able to take an early lead.
9-4.
Oh, nice flip.
7-4.
Again, their ability to attack the serve definitely gave them the edge in this match. Due to some flight issues, the team that wins this semifinal will actually be the Opens Doubles champions. They would have faced Chen Bowen and Sun Jianhao this morning. However, they're already on a flight back to their respective home states on the East Coast. And so the Indonesian team will be the 2015 Butterfly Badger Open Doubles Champions. We'll bring you more rounds of the under 2500 semifinals as they happen here on Table 1.
Blue or white? Blue.
one. Same position to side, sir.
Side.
Okay.
2 minutes.
Four, one, go, zero, ten. Oh! serve 0-0.
Thank you.
5-4. Thank you.
Same colors, blue, white, who want to choose?
White.
White. Still receive to side?
Receive.
Receive. Side? 2 minutes warming up.
For those of you joining us online, we are back at the 2015 Butterfly Badger Open. We're in the semifinals of the under 2500. And on the table now, we have Ernesto from New York City in the black and green, and Zhang Tong from Mississippi College in the yellow. These matches are best 3 out of 5. Winner advancing into the finals, and will play Rajat Hubli, who had just beaten Danny Seemiller 4-0 in the other semifinal. This is not an easy match for either player. Both players will have to play hard in order to maintain any kind of advantage here. Pretty evenly matched, with, I would say, Ernesto having a little bit of an advantage. Thank you.
I can see the ball, why am I not responding to it?
4-7.
Come on. Still serves, still serves. Come on.
7-5.
won this game.
This game. Won this game.
Thank you.
Three, five.
Thank you.
went to serve. 0-0.
Welcome to the Butterfly Badger Open. This is the 2500 match, semi-final. First prize is $700. Well, you know they're pretty serious. Ebuin from New York, the number one seed, against Tong Zhang in the yellow from Mississippi. Waiting in the final is Rajat Hubli, who just beat me, Dan Seemiller, in the semifinals, where I happened to blow a 7-0 game lead and a 10-6 lead. So I just came over here and I'm not feeling the greatest, but I can't believe I could blow a lead like that, Barbara. Come on. What the hell is going on? Sorry about that. I have so much trouble later in my career now closing, but I try not to, I guess best not to talk about it because it's been getting on me for sure. But I played pretty well, even making the semifinals, so here we go. It's 2-1. Ebuin's down.
And now we're in 2-2 in this best of five.
Tong Zhang, he's known for the great shot that saved Mississippi College in the teams where they were down match point and he had a big loop to his forehand.
He just counter-looped it like...
He did. He counter-looped it in and then he played another two good points and they won the match and won the title. And when that counter-loop went in, I just thought that really was clutch.
Yeah.
And it was not a weak loop. The guy opened, whoever it was, opened strong. It might have been Feng Shea. And it looked like a winner and he re-looped it in and then... Everything changed, and then Texas Wesleyan lost their...
Lost some of that energy.
Well, they had 12 in a row, too, and then all of a sudden it went from 13 to back to zero.
Zero, yeah.
So Tong Zhang, 2-2, the 2,500. Ebuin from New York, he's actually rated 2,520. His rating went up after the deadline, so he's eligible. And Hubley, who you'll see in a little bit, is an unusual, he's an Indian player, right? And he's got an inside-out loop, and it's very heavy spin, and he blocks, like, very well. And he has a lot of fight, and he has this banter that he says before he serves, hi, 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 boy, or something. And it was kind of cool. Okay, here we go, game five.
Go!
Nice return of serve there, dead ball by Tong, but Ernesto came in and flipped it.
And Tong was up 2-1 here.
Another good return of serve. Backhand to backhand they go.
There's that forehand counter loop.
Great point. Look at this.
Oh, wow.
Give Edwin some credit, boy. He had to cover the whole course, and then he had to run back to his backhand to save that one ball. Big second point. Edwin holds off the serve two in a row, so he's in a catbird seat here in game five. Side under, beautiful
right
opening.
Into the middle.
Nice opening, and Tong goes quickly to the timeout. Ernesto, definitely a fighter. He has a good table game, he can block well.
And big forehand, how he won that counter looping rally.
Well, and he can block too. He's got, you know, the players from Philippines in a lot of those areas, sometimes their techniques on the short game aren't as good, but boy, they can block and rally like the Indian player that'll be next. You know, his short game might not be that good, but he blocks so well that he covers for it. So 3-0, Ernesto, the number one seed. And I was actually the number two seed with Hubley number three. So he beat me
in
the final. Yeah, I played probably a few thousand matches. That one right there goes into the top 10 for hacking it away. Move that one into about number 7.
Fine.
You think I'd learn by now, but you know, sports don't necessarily take learning because you have to do. All right, here we go. Let's see if that timeout helped.
Yeah, sure helped yesterday in that open singles final.
It sure did. You're right. I thought about that last night. The change of serve, how it changed the whole match. Oh, nice return.
Oh!
Very good return by Tong, but a little early on the backhand. And Ernesto with four consecutive points to start game five.
Right. It's a tough comeback. Not impossible.
Let's see if Tong's probably going to go with that dead ball serve, but Ernesto's been pretty aggressive with it. No, that's under.
Well, they really can block.
Wow. A nice block, and Tong is getting the advantage, but he's down, and just, you know, Ernesto's using that athleticism. It doesn't get any sweeter than 5-0, but you can never rest on your laurels.
You can never rest.
In these short games, I lost from 7-0 about 8 minutes ago. I can laugh about it now, but it hurts. Nice return of serve again.
Here's that backhand. Oh, the blocking is great.
Wow. Ever since down 2-1, Ernesto's just raised his game a whole level. You know, playing in New York against the, you know, in those Westchester tournaments and in New Jersey and that area, boy.
So many great players to
practice
against.
So many. Maryland, you know, if you play at that level, that's how you get good.
No, attack the ball.
The first miss on the block in this game.
$2,500 semis, and then followed up will be the final shortly after. The Badger Open, 248 entries.
Oh, nice loop off the serve. Serve went a little long.
Yeah, you know, the hardest thing as you get older, and I don't know if there's an answer to it, it's your nerves kind of get tougher with you. And Ernesto's definitely an older player, and Tong is young. See if that plays a role.
Wow.
Yeah, you can see Ernesto feeling just a little bit of pressure. A beautiful shot there by Tong.
Oh, really nice.
He gave the dead ball serve. Ernesto spun it, but he didn't spin it real well. But
stepped around
the anticipation was perfect.
Straight down the line.
There we go. 3-6.
Again.
Wow. Pretty good spin, but not good enough. And then the counterattack. Tong, and that's his specialty. It gives you something where you can loop it, but not really well. And then he takes over. It's a tough way to play. Ernesto up 5-0 quickly, 6-4.
Like you said, you cannot rest on your laurels.
Oh, well, my goodness. Great. That's clutch. Perfect read. And Ernesto struggling. If he has a timeout, perfect good time. There it is.
There it is.
Got, he needs it. Now we're maybe taking it at 6-4, but no, I think that was a good time.
Well, if he had made it 7-4, he may not have needed it.
This is such a strange game, you know, Gorb. I mean, the first 5 points, Ernesto played like he could miss, and then now it's the other guy playing like he can't miss.
And he's killing everything.
Yeah, it's like Ernesto didn't play poorly. All of a sudden, Tong made five winners. So a well-played 2,500 semis, folks, and we're right down to the end. So hope you're enjoying this live streaming from Butterfly and the Badger Open. Yesterday's matches, a lot of drama.
A lot of drama.
Nice. I mean, if you haven't seen it, you know, look it up online. You'll see the matches. Boy, seven game, good stuff. Fighting hard and loop to loop. That I even saw it in my sleep last night. A couple of those rallies. Here we go. 6-5. Let's see if Ernesto can get on. This is probably the breaking point right here.
This is it.
He goes 7-5. He's got a clear path. He goes 6-6. His nerves are going to be in trouble.
Oh.
Yeah, you can see it's just like me when out there. All of a sudden, it just kind of goes away, and then you're thinking, woo! What the heck? See, you made that yell, like, come on.
Chata, 6-6.
5-0 to 6-6. At least I know how it happens to others.
Wait.
Okay, that little help might help a little bit, that little delay. Sometimes that's nice.
Oh my goodness.
Can you believe Tong Zeng, in the last 7 points, he's played 2,700?
7-6. It's okay. Just keep playing.
Timeout didn't work.
Not quite.
Now this is the second breaking point. It goes 8-6. I guess every point matters. Here we go.
Oh, wow.
Oh. You just kind of open your mouth and go, oh. 8-6.
And the proof that counter loop.
And the truth is, every one of Ernesto's loops have landed short, and they've been a little high. But you know, you could easily mishit any of those.
And he hasn't missed a single one.
Here we go, 6-8.
Got it!
That breaks the ice. Got a nice little backhand spin in there. And Tong, the only thing I've seen Tong a little early on is backhand. 7-8.
Forehand counter looping. The last 7 points have been great. Totally just looking for another one of those.
Let's see what Ernesto goes with. Does he go high risk or does he stay safety? Nice and low.
Wants to open for sure.
Oh. Yep. Oh. Frustration. Sometimes it comes in and that's not good for you. I mean, you want to try to think clearly and you get frustrated. It's hard.
Seven.
And what would you be thinking if you're Ernesto right now? How would you return this serve?
Yeah, I just would, you know, I would have to make sure that my first opening was quality. If not, I wouldn't do it. Oh, geez, that didn't work. Can you imagine 5-0? He's feeling like me. Maybe me and him will go over and have a nice tea or something. And we'll say, yeah, okay. We're both old guys. And it happens in every sport. Golf, guys can't putt. Table tennis, old guys can't close.
Here we go.
See,
there it is.
Go. It was like he was on the beam. He got knocked off it by some good play by Tong, and then he never recovered.
Yeah.
He never recovered. And feel bad.
And Tong played great. He didn't miss hit anything.
Yeah, I mean, Ernesto could say, hey, if you miss hit even one or two of those balls, the match was over. 5-0, it would have been over. But let's give Tong Zeng credit. He's in the final, and we're going to have a good final for you. We have a Rajat Hubli, an Indian player with an inside-out loop that's not technically sound, but boy, it works from the backhand side.
It really does.
Wide forehand, he's got a lot of problems, so I think Tong is going to be looping out there. But you'll see good blocking, and Tong's got, it should be a nice matchup.
It should really be a nice
match. It should be a good
match.
One. So stay tuned. That'll be up probably in
a couple of minutes.
Yeah, not more than 10 minutes.
Tong,
I think he just
Tong
said, did you say 10 minutes? Yeah. So 10 minutes, we'll be back.